My base salary is $148,600. My signing bonus was about $56,000.
How much more were you able to negotiate?
I was able to push things up, I'd say, about 5%.
My first job offer, which was from Amazon for a data analyst role, I actually negotiated $10,000 extra. And my last job, I was able to negotiate $100K extra. So have you compared your salary to your coworkers? And do you feel like you're making less than them?
Once you're already in, it's a little difficult to negotiate.
Hi, everybody. I'm currently in Seattle at the Amazon headquarters, and we're going to go around and ask people what mistakes they made when they accepted their job offers. So we're going to learn about all the salary negotiation mistakes. So keep watching till the end because we're going to talk to a lot of people. Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Yeah, my name is Evan. I'm a software engineer at Amazon working on an automotive product.
That is really cool. Can I ask how much money do you make?
Yeah, so the total compensation is broken down into base salary, stocks, and a signing bonus. So my base salary is $148,600. My signing bonus was about $56,000. And my stock grant was 130K over 4 years.
Okay, and what is the total compensation?
I think annually, if you were to break it down with stocks, it would be about 220, somewhere around there.
Okay, wow. Not a lot of people are transparent about sharing their salary, but you were super transparent. Can I ask you why?
Yeah, I think most of this information is pretty publicly accessible online anyways. And I think it's important to know where you stand in the market if you're looking to go into engineering. Tech is an industry where there's no reason why you should ever be underpaid. And so I think knowing what other people are making is really helpful for that.
That's awesome. And can I ask you, did you negotiate your salary?
I did not. I think it's a little higher because I live in California, so the cost of living is slightly higher, but I didn't do any negotiations beforehand.
And is this your first job?
Yeah, this is my first job.
Out of college?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I ask, where did you go to school?
I went to Cornell in New York.
Okay, yeah. Awesome. So let's say if you were to go back into job search phase and get your second job, do you plan to negotiate? If so, what do you plan to do?
Yeah, I think it would depend. If I had multiple offers, I would feel really comfortable negotiating. If I was really struggling and could only get like one offer, then I guess I would struggle to negotiate, or I think I probably wouldn't.
Do you talk to your coworkers about your salaries and their salaries? Is that a topic that you feel comfortable talking to them about?
Actually, I don't think I do. I don't know if it's really just like a comfort thing, but it just seems like a weird subject to bring up in a workplace.
Yeah. So let's say if you find out that your coworkers are making 280K, how would you that make you feel?
I think if they're the same level and same amount of experience as me, then I would probably be a bit disgruntled and start talking to my manager about why I'm on the lower end of the range. But I think right now, because I'm so inexperienced, I think what I have is pretty fair. So I guess it would depend on like time and how much time I spend in the industry, how much experience I can bring, et cetera.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. I appreciate how transparent you are.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Yeah. Hi, my name is Ishpreet Singh and I'm a senior product manager at AWS.
Wow. AWS. So can I ask you, like, when you joined AWS as a product manager, did you negotiate your salary?
I actually did not, because when I first joined AWS, or rather Amazon, I joined in a different job family and a different job function. So at that time, I did not negotiate, and midway through, I transitioned into the product manager role. And once you're already in, it's a little difficult to negotiate.
I love that you said that, because that's what I tell people. Like, you actually have more lever to negotiate your salary before you actually join versus when you're actually already there. So let's say if you were to, how long have you been here?
About 3.5 years.
3.5 years. So have you compared your salary to your coworkers, and do you feel like you are making less than them?
I mean, unofficially, yes, because it's a little it's a little difficult to ask someone how much they make. But, you know, I constantly research on different websites like Glassdoor, Blind, LinkedIn, and the total compensation that I see for folks who are in a similar job family with a similar experience, they're definitely making more than what I make. So.
And how does that make you feel?
Not so great.
You know, that was my first job too, and I did not feel that great as well. But one thing I did do is, like, I went outside and I started interviewing. Would you ever consider doing that?
Actually, see, it depends on a lot of different factors, right? Because your total compensation is not the only factor. It's also about job security, how many hours you're putting in, and, you know, what is the associated dollar value if you compare your total compensation as compared to the number of hours you work. Right. So, and also depends on, you know, how passionate about what product you're working on. So, like, I'm a product manager, so I'm really passionate about the product that I work on and I enjoy working on it. Mm-hmm. So that's why if I were to make a switch, salary or total compensation would not be the only factor that I would consider.
I love that you said that. If you were to like go for another job search down the road, not right now, yep. Down the road, you go do that. What will you do differently?
First of all, I would do my proper due diligence, right? For research, you know, what are different folks who are working in a similar job family or similar job function in that particular company, how much they are making, you know, what's the average salary, and then also compare it with the market conditions at that point in time. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, accordingly proceed ahead with the negotiations if I were to proceed ahead in that direction.
Okay. Awesome. Yes. Thank you so much. That was great.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Excuse me. Did you negotiate your salary?
Are you talking to me?
Yes. I want to know, did you negotiate your salary?
You know what? That's a great question because I actually did. My first job offer, which was from Amazon for a data analyst role, I actually negotiated $10,000 extra. And my last job, I was able to negotiate $100,000 extra.
Wow. How did you do that?
Okay. There are so many strategies that you can use when it comes to negotiation. One is like having competing offers. Second is just the bare minimum, just asking for it. And there are so many other tips and tricks that you can use when it comes to salary negotiation, which I have curated and listed out over the last 10 years. In fact, in 2021, I helped other people negotiate $1.4 million in incremental job offers. So there's so much I have to share.
Where can I learn more?
I'm so glad you asked because I'm launching a masterclass on tech salary negotiation that teaches you tips, tricks, tools, and everything else in between. For example, do you know how to figure out your market rate if you're not a software engineer or if you are? Maybe you do, maybe you don't. Did you know you can actually project your 5-year salary based on the offer and use that as a data point to negotiate? No, right? I have actually created all of that in a template format that you can use and much more. And I'm confident anybody using that strategies can negotiate their salary successfully.
Where can I find that?
Oh, I'm actually going to link that in the description below. So check it out. And maybe your next job offer, you'll be able to negotiate $10,000 more or maybe $100,000. Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Hey, my name is Vaishali and I do analytics at Amazon.
Wow, Amazon. And we're currently at Amazon.
Yes.
So can I ask you, like, when you got your Amazon offer, did you negotiate your salary?
Oh, I tried, but I wasn't succeeded because I just accepted it because it was a big tech.
Because you saw the big tech job offer and you were like, I have to accept it.
Yeah.
You know what? That's a lot of people. That's actually me too, because I did that as well. But did you even try to negotiate? Like, why wasn't it successful?
I tried, but I didn't try hard. So I think I should have tried harder and I should have done market research and all. Yep.
What advice do you have for somebody who is either doing job searching, whether it's their first job, second job, third job? Do you have any advice for people who are going into salary negotiation?
Yeah, sure. I think one would be understand your market rate, and then it's helpful to you to negotiate a better offer. Second is find a competitive offer so that you can negotiate it better.
Awesome. I love the competing offer part because that definitely helps a lot because it definitely gives you a leg up. Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, what's your name and what do you do for a living?
Nick, and I'm an event producer.
And where do you work?
I work at Amazon.
How long have you been here?
I've been at Amazon for just about a month at this point, but been working in this field for over a decade.
Wow. So you just accepted a new job. Did you negotiate your salary when you got this job?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Could you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yeah, no, I think I just went into it knowing what the expectation for compensation was, what I was looking for total compensation, and just kind of understanding compensation structure as well, so that when an offer was presented, I knew how I was expecting to come back and counter and make that negotiation happen.
And can I ask if you're comfortable sharing, how much more were you able to negotiate?
I was able to push things up, I'd say about 5%, but at the beginning of my negotiations, I went in and basically said, you know, I understand this is the range that you're looking at. I'm hoping to be on the higher end of that, and basically illustrated, you know, where my skill sets lied, where my experience was, how I added value, and said that I wanted to start at the higher end of that point. They came in and provided an offer, and from there I came back and made a counter offer. I don't think ever take the first offer.
I love that. You are a pro at this. Can I ask, you're the fourth person I'm talking to today. You're the only person who has said that they negotiated their offer. Everybody else said that they just accepted what was given to them. What advice do you have for people who are either going in the salary negotiation or in the future will come across that?
Yeah, I mean, I would say, you know, when it comes to reviewing an offer and negotiating on that, they're always going to provide you one out the gates, obviously. And I think that there's always going to be room on the back end as someone who's dealt with hiring before to really explore what still exists there. You know, having hired a handful of folks myself, I always start out with a little bit lower offer than what I know I can provide on the higher end. So I'd say go in and at least make that first negotiation. And from there, you know, you may be able to push it up. They may say that that's the best we can do out the gates, but it never hurts to go advocate for yourself out the gates.
I love that. And you know, like one really powerful thing that you said is that whenever the company offers you, gives you the first offer, they leave some room for negotiation. So when you accept your first offer without negotiating, you're basically accepting the offer without negotiating and you're getting the lower end.
Yeah. No, I would say always go advocate for yourself. If nothing else, all they're going to say is this is the best we can provide, but at least you stepped up and advocated for yourself. And I think that's one of the most important things you can do.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Of course.
All right. That's all we had today. I hope you learned something from this video. If you did, let me know in comments and I'll see you next time. Have a beautiful day. Bye. Testing, testing. This is audio test. Testing, testing, testing. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1. Okay.